Hey guys, welcome back to Babe's Kitchen. Two things really quick. Number one, in my intro, that was my beautiful mom, who is no longer here. And number two, I want to wish a happy Mother's Day to all the beautiful moms around the world. I want to wish a happy Mother's Day to my beautiful second mom, Miss Yvonne, and my beautiful sisters, Debbie, Tracy, Nisha, and Shireen. Okay, so guys, so today, don't worry, I didn't have to cook anything. I had a wonderful breakfast, or brunch, I should say, with the family that they did for me. And for dinner, of course, you saw the title there. It's gonna be garlic lobster, shrimp, and mussels. Yeah, so I didn't have to cook anything, but I wanted to share it with you guys real quick and just tell you all the ingredients and what it took to make. And so this is a little different. I'm not actually making it because I didn't have to, but in the description, don't worry, everything is there, what was used and all the ingredients, okay? So let me show it to you. One second.
Oops. Gotta get it out, guys. Hello.
All right, I'm just gonna uncover it. One second. This is gonna be so delicious, guys. I can't wait for dinner. This is the beautiful platter of our garlic shrimp, mussels, and lobster. All right, so real simple, your lobster tails, they look black when you get them. So when you put them to boil, they're gonna, when they turn red, you know they're ready. And that's usually after about 10, 12 minutes, or even sooner sometimes. Corn, easy to boil. Mussels, these are the frozen mussels. That's what we usually get. So I told my husband, you know, what to get. I'll show you what package that came in. And shrimp, you could use raw shrimp or cooked shrimp, whichever you prefer, okay? I'm gonna put this down, it's kind of heavy, guys. So let me show you the mussels. I usually get mine in Walmart, but my husband went and got it someplace else. These are the frozen ones from, I think the market he went to was Publix, but whichever market, whichever one they have, whatever frozen one is good. This one already comes in garlic sauce, all right? And then with your shrimp, real easy to season. You put your favorite seafood seasoning. I usually like to add a little cayenne pepper. You can eliminate that if you don't want. You cut up your garlic cloves to add in when you're cooking the shrimp. And that's basically the seasoning for that. And then the lobster tails, after they boil, you drain off the water. And your sauce, so what you're gonna do, you're gonna have in the pot your margarine or your favorite butter and a little bit of olive oil. And you're gonna sprinkle some cayenne pepper if you like, if not, but you're gonna put all your garlic cloves in there. You're gonna need about maybe 8 garlic cloves or so, depending on how much you have. You're gonna chop them up and you're gonna put them in a pot, let that butter sauce cook down. And then you're gonna throw your lobster in there. Scoop it on, scoop that juicy gravy. All right, and then you're gonna take them out, and then you're gonna put your shrimp in that same gravy that's left over in there, your seasoned shrimp, which is seasoned with your favorite seasoning and cayenne pepper for color, or you can use paprika, it's up to you. Put it in there, let them cook on each side, and stir that juiciness, and you can get them out the pot. And like I said, the mussels, they already come in their own sauce, but you can throw them in that same sauce, mix it all together, stir it up. The mussels take really quick to cook. To be honest, I never did the raw mussels. I always get the pre-cooked ones. So the pre-cooked ones, I know they take about 8 minutes to cook, bam, and they're ready. So simple and fast. Corn, you know, that's easy. You just go ahead and boil it. And then whatever sauce is left in the pan, you can add a little bit more of your favorite butter or margarine, a little bit more olive oil. If you need more garlic cloves, you can chop up a little extra, put it in there, sprinkle a little cayenne pepper if you want to, but if not, that's fine. Let that cook down. That's gonna be your dipping sauce that you're gonna dip, you know, to get your extra juices in. All right, and that takes maybe 5 minutes to cook that down. Okay, so pretty fast and simple. I just wanted to share it with you guys real quick. And like I said, everything is in the description. And again, all you beautiful mothers, have a happy Mother's Day. And thank you guys for joining Babe's Kitchen once again. And we will see you later. Bye.